Hello, everybody. My name is Brian Souders, and I work with BRP on the Elevation Mountain blog and the Ski-Doo Mountain Facebook page. We are having our first webcast with Pascal Vincent, the Ski-Doo product manager, and we're going to be going over the Ski-Doo 2011 Summit, some of the new stuff, and also the new E-Tech 800R engine, plus taking the questions that you've sent to us via the Facebook page and comments on the blog. So without further ado, I'm going to kick it over to Pascal.
All right. Thank you, Brian. Hello, everybody. So I have the pleasure to present you the technical session on Model Year 2011 Summit. So let's go. What's new for 2011? I will talk about the new engine, the 800R E-Tech, and major changes that we brought on the Summit. Let's start with the 800R E-Tech. So this engine is built on the same crankcase as the PowerTech. It gets also the same porting as the P-Tech. Cylinder head is fully machined for consistent compression ratio, 12.5 to 1. There's also new piston. We do redesign the locating pin and have a 2 millimeter thick ring to ensure sealing, durability, and resistance to flutter. We do trade the two TM40 carbs to a throttle body, larger size for increased airflow and more power. Throttle effort is noticeably lighter with extremely linear power delivery. And finally, the same magneto as the 600 E-Tech, which is 1200 watt to activate the injectors. There's a new fuel injector with a larger fuel pintle and orifice to deliver 25% more fuel flow than the 600HO E-Tech injectors. On the ECM, we do have a new one. It's a more sophisticated four-driver circuitry. This new circuit uses two drivers for injecting fuel and two drivers for the return stroke. And this ensures stability needed to actuate the injectors at high RPM. We also have a higher voltage to drive the injectors, 60 volt versus 55. And this is to reduce the heat buildup within the ECU, inside of the ECU. There's also a warm-up mode, which is designed into this ECU. If the temperature, for example, is minus 20 degrees Celsius or greater, there's no warm-up needed. But if the temperature is below minus 25 degrees Celsius or minus 13 Fahrenheit, upon startup, the idle speed will automatically go to 1750 RPM. This RPM will give more electrical current to energize the electric coil in the oil pump. This in turn warm up the oil, reducing its viscosity. Very, very interesting technology there. Talking about the new pump, yes, there are more capacity for the bigger engine, more accurate delivery, and also featuring a feedback sensor. This extra electrical contact, the sensor, signals the ECU each time the oil pump piston completes one full stroke. This info is used during warm-up mode, and this is specific to 800R E-Tech engine.
All right, first, one of our questions from our readers online. Ted wanted us to discuss the break-in process for the E-Tech 800R and if it was any different, let's say, than the 600 E-Tech.
Yes. In fact, for the 800 E-Tech, we have a fuel use bay break-in, meaning that the break is not complete until 120 liter of fuel that have been consumed. So we are talking about 3 tanks of fuel or about. So depending upon driving style and speed, this may take some time. So if you are gentle on the throttle, you will use less fuel, so it will take longer time. So during braking, the oil consumption is as high as 33 to 1 at high RPM. So don't forget that the higher is the RPM, the more oil will be consumed during and after the braking. So bottom line, because the electronic will control the whole system, just ride it as usual. Don't be too gentle or too rough on the throttle. Just ride it as usual.
All right, another question that's been a popular one is, why is BRP using full synthetic and recommending full synthetic oil in the E-Tech 800R when the 2010 and a half limited builds were filled and recommended with semi-synthetic?
Yeah, it's a good question. But in fact, with the extensive testing over the last year, we have demonstrated that the full synthetic oil is far superior to run in our sled. And, you know, the best engine technology needs the best oil technology, and this is especially true with the new E-Tech engine. You will see lower fuel consumption, less smoke, and better engine performance, and much cleaner cylinder, piston, and rings with this new full synthetic oil. We do recommend the semi-synthetic. Semi-synthetic is the minimum oil required to put in an E-Tech engine. But the full synthetic oil is a better engine. So if you want to babysit your engine, let's go with the full synthetic oil. And because we know you want the best, guys, we filled all the models with 800 E-Tech engine with the full synthetic oil right from the factory. Let's talk about emission. The 800R E-Tech has the lowest emission on the market. Look at the graph. Competitors are far behind. What's interesting is even the PowerTech is cleaner versus the competition. Interesting. If we look at the NER, which is the normalized emission rate, it's the a number that EPA asks every manufacturer, OEM, to put on their hand tag. The E-Tech is 4.6 on the left side of the scale, which is 0 to 10. While the other are more on the right side of the scale. Again, a cleaner technology. Power. Yes, we do have more horsepower. But why are we talking about 155 plus? It's simply because we're more conservative. We want to make sure that if you guys putting the engine on the dyno, you will get at least 155. And guess what? Dynotech Research already put the engine on their dyno and they found 163.9 horsepower. This is tons of power. And for those of you who tried the vehicle, you can notice it. There is something there. There is more power than the PowerTech. There's not only more power from the engine, but there's also an interesting thing. It's the dual air entry. The benefit is easy breathing from both sides of the sled. Snow, it doesn't get plugged, so depending on which side you're carving. And also it gives a kind of visual cue to set the 800 E-Tech apart versus the PowerTech. Consumer benefit. Obviously, there's no compromise on that. It delivers more 163. It's still there. And there's no change between the prototypes that maybe some of you tried versus the full production version. It sets new benchmark in terms of fuel and oil economy. But I want to bring the attention to you guys on MXZ and Renegade fuel and oil economy versus Summit. MXZ Renegade, 14% better on fuel, and 30% better on oil. While on the Summit, we're talking about up to 12% better than P-Tech, but same oil consumption as the PowerTech. Why is that? Simply because there's more time where you are using wide open throttle. So we wanna be, again, more conservative, and we think you can reach up to 12% depending how hard you will be on the throttle. Other key attributes of E-Tech: low emission, low smoke, smooth idle, and a premiere in the industry is the automatic cylinder fogging that features only the E-Tech. And finally, the computer control break-in period.